All right, y'all. I want to try and show some stuff that I think maybe is different from what you may have seen on Marvin Sapp's Never Would Have Made It. And I'm encouraging people to take it and kind of make it their own. Of course, keep the melody recognizable. But there's some cool things you can do, especially if you have a bass player in place, which most worship groups will. And that I think can make it really cool. So I'm without a sustain pedal, and I've just got a bare bones recording to play behind me here. So I'm going to kind of go through it once, kind of playing the melody, and then I'm just going to go through it once comping, and then we'll try to show you what we're doing. And I'm going to check on the video camera, see if you can see that finger. Yes, you can. All right, so here we go. So that's kind of interesting. I like that chord because you got this whole 7, 3, 6, 2, 5 cycling thing going on. So I'm going to try to get into it pretty quick here. If you got a good bass player, you can play, you can basically leave this side of the keyboard alone as far as establishing a bass note because he'll be doing that. And that leaves you free to play a bunch of these two-handed voicings like this. So here's what I like to do, and I'm going to check one more time to see if my camera's picking up those fingers right there. So I start out right here with this C, and this is, like C right here, right? All right, we're going to make it a major 7th, and then keep that, and we're going to go, in the key of C, this will be the 7th, the 3rd, the 6th, the 2, 5, and the 1. So you spread your chords all the way out like that. And then it's going to go B, E to A. Never could have made it. And what I'll play for that, what do I play for that? It's really anything will work there. It's a B, half diminished, so the regular chord would be like B, D, F, A. So I'll put this A here, a D here, and an F here, and then just kind of repeat it up here, A, B, D, F. And then you're coming at this from, then you're headed to an A, you're gonna hit an E. All right, that's not really in this tutorial, but it's something that you can always add anytime you're going, whatever your target note is, just go down to the 5 and kind of walk it up like that. So far we've got, sorry, there's my C. Never would have made it. So we're gonna hit an E. This is like an E7 here. So I take this, and then this is the 9th here. And you have two options up here. You can hit a 13th and a 1 and a 5, or you can go 5, 1, 5. So never would have made it. And I like to hit that root note, because that's melody. All right, then you got A. A is like, you know, this. And that makes it the minor seventh with the nine. So we're going to take the seventh and we're going to stretch it out. You're going to hit that note, B, E, A. So G, C, F sharp, B, E, A. So far we got. Now we're going to a G and we're going to hit a D. We're going to go D, G. So for the D, I like to do just a chromatic slide down. Like do a substitution with A flat down to G instead of D to G. Anytime you're going from, you know, cycling in fifths, like this is, you know, anytime you're going 1, 7, 3, 6, 2, 5, you know, you can always substitute the chromatic above your target note for the previous note. So if, in this case, you know, if you're in C and you're gonna go B, E, A, you can always go C, B, B flat, A. In this case, we're going A, D, G, so we're gonna go A, A flat, G. So this would be, it works because see this note here and this note here are the same, they share notes with A flat 7. So what we're going to do, instead of doing this regular A flat 7 going to G, we're going to put the 7th of the A flat here, C, F, B flat, E flat, A flat. Then we're going to hit a G minor. Instead of this kind of, maybe that kind of G minor, we're going to put F, B flat, E, A, D, G. And so then you can do the same combination again. You can go either G, C, F, or you can go G, G flat, F. And the cool thing is to play a G flat, 7, but use the C. And then when you hit a F sharp down to the F, hit the C, 7 in your right hand. Okay, so there's our A flat down to G. See that? So far we have. Never could made it. Never would have made it. Now you can hit C or G flat here. We're going to do a C, we're going to hit the E, B flat, D, and then you have the option of hitting A, C, G, or G, C, G. If you're going to do the F sharp chord, you have E, B flat, E flat, A flat, D, F sharp. I'm sorry, D flat, F sharp. And it slides right into an F major 7th. Instead of doing an F major 7th like this, we're gonna do like this, E, A, D, G, C, F. I could have lost it all. Alright, so let's see if we can get back to the beginning of this and run through this a little. This is a lot of material to cover, and I don't know how to cover it and really explain it all, except for just to show it. And you just have to pause the video and play along, I guess. Anywhere you can do this cool deal where you move. Oh, y'all, I got to go to another video. Just watch part two. I don't know what to say. Watch part two.